Thank you, thank you. Happy holiday.
Happy holiday.
This is the last holiday before the school begins. I'm excited. Please eat well. And the school is going to go fast, right? And then by the time you blink your eyes, it'll be Thanksgiving. And you'll be so tired. And you'll have the last meal before the finals. So enjoy this weather. I want you to enjoy. Okay, we have been doing a big picture, so I want to give you the survey of what the Bible is about, the big picture. So I just introduced the picture. And then last week what we did. Remember? Last week we did our creation, okay, turn chapter 1. And then this week we went to the fall. And the next week we'll do redemption and the restoration. So we are skipping the whole Bible in four lessons. But I just give you a big, big chunk so that you can have a big picture. So what's the big picture? So if you ask your friend, what is the Bible about? So what is it? What is the Bible? So I think there are many verses in the Bible, but it's good. But I always go back to Luke chapter 24:44. Let's read that. But that has been our key verse for the last lesson. Let's read that, Luke 24:44. Just get the what's Bible about. So what is the Bible about? So let's read. If you have a Bible, please, if you don't have a Bible, please do share. Because this is very important, okay? Who doesn't have a Bible? Okay, and then this is very important verse for you. So Joe, put it on the screen, okay? Luke 24, verse 4. Luke chapter 24:44. Okay, ready? Who wants to read for us? Okay, in front of the voice. Oh, early bird Mike can read us, okay? All right.
Okay, I gave this message on Easter, so...
Okay, let's read it.
He said to them, "This is what I told you while I was still with you. Everything must be fulfilled, as written about me, in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms."
Okay, so Bible is about what? Okay, about me. It's not me, okay? It's about Jesus. So we are thinking about, there is another way to look at Bible. Bible is about Jesus. So I propose that. And so that's why we are studying the various Bibles, so that to love Jesus. And this is my plan. And let's go to the next slide. So Joe is slow, because he didn't have a sleep last night. Let's pray for Joe. He has a new baby. And then the lunch was provided by Joe, so let's give a thanks. So he's a new father. Okay, so the next one is the fall. In chapter 3, I picked the key verse. Let's look at our key verse together, and I'll talk about this key verse. And let's read together. Okay? I realize that one of my weaknesses, there are many weaknesses, but the crucial weakness is that I don't listen very carefully. My beloved wife has been talking to me for many, many years, okay? I mean 20 years. And I told her, hey, what did you do? I listen very carefully. I'm a PC. I listen to teacher. So, for example, she brought out this example. And then one day she asked me to buy some beef. So I went to Korea, Chicago, Korean market. And she said, oh, give me some beef. So I said, oh, basuk beef, okay? Basuk beef, okay, I'll go and buy basuk beef, okay? And then I thought, because I know that I have a tendency to not to listen, okay? So I called her. I called her and I said, hey, I'm at the Korean market. You said beef, right? I said, yeah. So I bought the box of frozen beef, okay? And then the next day she said, no, that's not what I asked. It's marinated beef. Guests are coming and it's frozen. What do you mean? I talked to you on the phone. Oh, then I thought, I think that, okay? I think I listen, but I don't listen. So as a man, we have lots of brothers, so let's pray for brothers, including myself. Listen to one another. I know you are all different places, but let's pray for God's grace and listen to it. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the grace of Jesus. Thank you for the Bible. Please help us to listen to you. And we know some people are happy and some people are sad. And some people are neutral and no emotions. But grant us your joy through the word of Jesus and Jesus. And see who you are and also who we are. And then finally, we can find Jesus in the Bible. I pray this to you.
Amen.
So this is the prayer. I've been this one. So Genesis chapter 3 is about, not us, because Luke chapter 24 says the Bible is about Jesus. So first of all, I talk about who God is. Who's God? So we have different ideas. And then we'll talk about, look at Genesis chapter 3 and find out who we are before God. And we'll do Luke chapter 24:44, check, okay? So you can study all the Bible you want, but you cannot miss the first point. Okay? So the Bible is about Jesus. So after you get the chapter 3, and then, okay, where's Jesus? And then I'll try to look at the Jesus and the connection between the chapter 3, our 4. And then, the important question is, so what? Okay? The knowledge will not save us, but the power of God that works in us will save us. So the question is, for what? So that's my plan. So first of all, who is God? So we have some different ideas, because I go to the University of Illinois, and there are so many clubs there. And then some people say, there is only one God. Our Muslim brothers and the Christians and the Jewish people. So there's only one God, okay? Right? And then there are Hindu brothers, but there are many gods. And then there are some people say there are only two gods, the evil and then good, good and evil, okay? And then our atheist brothers, you know, if you go to Thursday English building, they were meeting there. So I go there, you know, every day, every week, and then I try to irritate them. You know. And then they said, there's no God. But they talk about non-stop. I said, there's no God. Then why you talk about non-stop? Even if you say there's no God, then that can be your God. And then they talk about non-stop. And then some people say, there's no, I don't know. I'm not here. So, because there are many ways, but I think God is, who's God? God is the ultimate thing that controls you. So I want to know who God is. And then we have many different ideas. And then I use worship chemistry God. Chemistry God. And then some people worship other gods, but like that, God is ultimate. That it makes me get up in the morning, drive you, and then make you passionate about something. Or if your God is very sleepy God, then you make a sleepy all day long. So God is the ultimate. We cannot escape, because even our basic brothers cannot escape God. So God is everywhere. But before that, there are many ways to look at God, who God is. But I want to look at Genesis chapter 3 and find out who God is. And as I told you that I don't listen very well, so let's pray one more time. Dear Lord, thank you for the word of God. Without your word, we don't know who God is, and we don't know who we are, and we miss the main point of the Bible. Please grant us your words, so that we can find you, and find Jesus, and so our life can be changed by the grace of Jesus. Mm-hmm. May the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be pleasing and praying to you.
Amen.
Okay. So, who God is? You know, I'm trying to give you a survey. This is just a survey, so if you want to study, please find your Bible teacher and study the Bible, one to one. But this is a survey. And this is my city, who God is. Can you refresh one more time, because there's always a refresh it. Go there and then get the Google Drive impression. So there's cache, okay. So it's always like we have problem with the technology. Mm-hmm. He gets the up ready, so close the browser. Okay. Here, I'm going to talk about who that is. In chapter 3, I want to propose that God is good, and his love in this world. That's my main point. God is good, and his love in this world. We do not know, because I was not there in the garden. I have no idea why I think. And we have different ideas, because we are living in this world, and we look at the newspaper and everything, and we think that we know one thing, that this is not kingdom garden, okay? Kingdom mm-hmm. garden, okay? It's not perfect. It doesn't take too long. Look around, and it doesn't take too long to know that something is wrong with this world, okay? So how do you believe that this is a perfect world? Raise your hand. No? What? And then where the evil comes from? Some people say, the very easy answer is that God is two persons put an evil, okay? And then God created evil. That's the St. Augustine's argument. Before he became a saint, he used to borrow the word in religion, he says, God is good and evil. But it explains everything. So he looked at the world and said, hey, there's evil, good and bad. So God must be good. You know, two persons. So that's very easy question. But in Genesis chapter 3, and especially chapter 2 and 1 and 2, God is good. God made everything good. There is nothing bad. And then you go to chapter 3, and then we see something terrible happen. And then we can say, oh, because God is bad, so we become bad. So we can blame God. But if you read Genesis chapter 3 very carefully, there is no hint of evil in God. So I'll say Dr. Augustine, the doctor of church. Augustine said, he's my mentor, he says, evil is not created by God. But the evil is misusing our free will. Because God gave us free will. Without this free will, it's not perfect. You have freedom to choose. Do you believe that you have freedom to choose? Do you have freedom to go to school or not to go to school? Of course, your parents will be upset, but ultimately, you have freedom. Right? Every morning, you have freedom to get up or not get up. Right? Every night, you have freedom to go or sleep or go to the bar or drink. Do you have freedom or not? Of course, you have freedom. Okay? So, if you don't have freedom, then we are robots, okay? We are controlled by the outside. God always tells you what to do, okay? But Augustine says in confession that he was looking at that. He says, we have this evil. And then the evil comes when we do not use proper this way. And then this is what happened to Adam. The first man and his wife, me, misuse the freedom that God gave them, and the whole universe came. So we cannot really blame God for what we have done. Of course, it's easy to blame. But when you look at chapter 3, the serpent comes, but it's not God. And then the desire comes to us, and he made a mistake. Right? So I still believe that it's not God to cause the evil, but it's us, and we are responsible for that. And this is what happened. And if you believe the Bible is true, then this is what God says. God made the world perfect, gave them free will, perfect freedom, but somehow we did not use God's freedom to the good or to the evil. And then something happened. So anybody join up with the girl? No? No brothers? God, we're anti-social. Oh, they didn't know, okay, watch out. But they don't know how, okay? So teach them how. But think about that. You know, you go out with a girl, and you give your heart, your love, and your money, and then you confess your love, right? I love you. And then the girls respond back to you, I love you. And they find out she's playing with the other guy. That's a missing experience. That's what we did. That's what our personal Adam did. He heard the voice of God. Said, you cannot do this. If you do this, everything will collapse. And you'll die. And so for him, the man said, hey, God is lying to you. God is good. Kiss, you know, he's trying to hide something. Please, do something. Ignore God's word. Go ahead. You're not going to die. You'll live forever. And you'll be God. And then, he even looked at the tree. It was so beautiful, pleasing. And then, wow, she just said, wow. And then, ate it, bite. And then he gave to us that they all ate. And then, why? The word of God came in truth. Suddenly, we realized, what? They're naked. Okay? Naked by the beautiful. But Adam had a perfect body, okay? And Eve has a perfect body. But they were ashamed. Shame came. And they began to die. What will you do? What will you do? Let me ask a question. What will you do? You gave somebody your heart, everything they need, you know, every your ounce of energy, and then they betrayed you. What can you do? Okay. Come on. You have three ways that you can kill that person, okay? Number two, you forget about it and take a bunch of drugs, okay? Number three, you kill yourself. You have to do three ways, okay? Three ways to go. Three ways to go. Let me tell you all God. God knows everything. God knows that they betray their trust. But God comes to Adam and says, where are you? Where are you? And then he says, in the cool of the day. So I like it because God is cool. He's not emotional, okay? He doesn't commit the passion in God, okay? He's cool, cool of day. And I ask him, where are you? The person who betrayed your trust, and God comes to you and asks him, hey, where are you? Do you see the grace of God? Do you see how much he has to control himself and go to you and say, where are you? Knowing that you betray your trust. Do you see the grace of God? How good that God is? Do you see? It's hard. You want the person you scratch you, who hurt you, and you abandon you. But God goes to you and say, where are you? God has been calling everyone. Where are you? Because he knows that you are off track. He knows everything. But he says, where are you? So I want to really feel a good God who comes to you. And then he gives you hope and the solutions. Because once you're messed up, you're messed up. And this kind of relationship problem, no amount of work, you cannot really, you know, when you are betrayed by your like mother, it's almost impossible to patch up. And then he says, I will put enmity between you and you and the woman, between your offspring and hers. He'll cross your head and you will strike his heel. So I think it's very good to know that he gives you hope. This is an impossible situation, but he gives you hope. Do you see the trace of God? He's like that, the defeat, like a sigh. At first when you mess up, we always say, but I don't see it. This is the most victorious verse in the Bible. This is the one I go when I mess up. This is the one who gives us much, 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 much hope when we see it. So I want to see it. So I want to celebrate this victorious verse together with you today. Do you see it? It's victorious, okay? But it's kind of bloody, but it's good. I like it. So let's read together. And let's read 3:15. Okay, let's read that, okay? I'll put enmity between you and the woman, between your offspring and hers. You'll cross your head and you will start to hear. So that's who God is. And then who we are. Okay, so we have many ideas about who we are. Who are you is a question. But the Bible tells us that in Genesis chapter 1, God made us. And Genesis 1:27, he made us in the image of God. And then, Genesis chapter 3, we betray God's trust. And we are tempted. So the reality of us is that we are always tempted. I wish there's no temptation. But without, you know, God gave fullness, so we are all tempted. So every morning, I'm tempted not to help. Sleep more. And then every time I have some paper to do, and we got to wait until last minute. I'm tempted like that. So we are tempted. And also, we are not that strong. And then we have the deep sense of shame in us. So let's go to Facebook. Facebook is good because we connect to each other, we want to share with our friends who we are. But I don't think that nobody shares 100% who they are because they're ashamed. They want to hide something. You want to project your nice face. But as long as you share your how bad you are and what kind of thinking you are doing, and you have no friends. I'm serious. Go ahead. Okay, try that. Next day, I'm still with this and this bad, and I have this temptation that. And you just go isolate people. And then we wear the fig tree, fig crown. And I said, I look at our fig tree, and then we have a crown. It's, you know, it's not good. And then every fig tree comes every year. Okay? It's not lasting. I mean, we try, you know, we think that we can hide, but we can't. We need God. God doesn't need us, but we need God. We have to hear the voice of God. When God says, where are you? When God says, I'll crush the head of Satan, and then he'll strike his heel. We have to see, we have to hear his gentle voice, assurance, and then we have to hear victory. But we don't hear it. Somehow, we want to hear our own ideas, and we don't hear God. God gave us good news, but we don't hear it. I don't know why I don't hear it, but that has been my problem. I told my wife for 20 years. I told her, hey, you tell me, then I don't hear. Then I said, text me, then I hear, okay? I read it. But well, she texts me, then but still I don't hear it, okay? I'm encouraging her. I said, a person beyond hope. And then at that time, where I go? Go to my wife, and I go to Genesis 3. And I want to hear the goodness of God. Your enemy is destroyed. Because I gave myself to you. I want to hear that. So, I know. This is overwhelming. This is the worst chapter in the Bible because of this, everything came falling down. But I want to hear God. Who loves us without any comparison comes to me. Speaking truth in love. It tells you how bad you are. How messed up you are. But he keeps his love. And he comes to me. And then he doesn't leave you alone. And you know, he's asked you, where are you? And then he said, you cannot solve your problems. I'll kill myself. And here come. And then restore you. I'm God who made the heavens and earth. And I said, I will fix it. Can you hear that? Are you happy with that? Or can you tell me something else? So I want to really hear the voice of God here. And I know that when you leave this life, I wish that you are successful 100%. Or take any class in the grades. Any relationship you go, and then you're like, wonderful, perfect. Any, like, endeavor you do, you do a good job. But I don't think so. I don't think so. You know? I don't think so. Like, kinds of people like me, I fail. Every day I fail, you know? And I don't understand me. Because I thought I'm strong, but not that strong. And then I go here and then hear the voice of God say, I know you, what you have done last night. But tell me where you are. Can I help you? I give you the good news. There's a victory stored for you. And then God met my heart. I think this is goodness. And this is power. And then it's not just what God said, but this is what God has done through our Lord Jesus Christ. So let's look at the connection between, let's look at the connection between Paul and Jesus. Okay. We Christians believe that Jesus fulfilled